y'all doing this morning?
All right.
All right. It's good to see y'all. Yeah, y'all sitting there looking like y'all been sucking on lemons. Y'all need to start smiling or something. Amen. Almost made me scared to get up here. We're so glad to be in this place. Amen. If you cannot smile in the house of God, there's no other place you can go. Amen. We give honor to an awesome God that allowed us to one more opportunity to give him praise. To the deacon staff, to the choir that has sung so beautifully this morning, all of my father's children here at the Morning Star family and on the web. We have our graduates here, and we're so glad to have them with us. Amen. One particular, Brother Darius Leggett, him and my son Juwan played ball together. And it's a coincidence how God works, because he also called me his pastor here. And when I found out who his grandparents and daddy were, I started trying to hook them back together. Amen. And lo and behold, God is so good that he honors our requests. Amen. It's nothing like having family. Amen. If family is not there for you, there's nobody else that will be there for you. And I tell you that I'm a firm believer in family. A lot of people don't have the opportunity to meet their family. Amen. Or if you get the opportunity, they have heard so much that they don't want to meet their family. Amen. But lo and behold, when mended fences are being mended, amen, it's a good opportunity to love on one another. Amen. Amen. That was something for free, y'all. Something for free. Glad to have my family with me. Got my brothers and mom and aunt and grandma. They all sitting right there on that second row. Yeah, look at that boy. They're looking good too right there. Yeah. Got some good looking folks, boy, I tell you. All right. Hey, it's a faux frog on croaking his own pond. Amen. Amen. I'm not gonna hold you long. Turn with me to a very familiar passage of Scripture, Luke chapter 15. And we'll start reading at verse 11. And it reads like this. There was a man who had two sons. The younger one said to his father, "Father, give me my share of the estate." So he divided his property between them. Not long after that, the younger son got together all that he had, set off for a distant country, and there squandered his riches in wild living. After he had spent everything, there was a severe famine in the whole country, and he began to be in need. So he went and hired himself out of the citizen of that country, who sent him to his field to feed the pigs. He longed to fill his stomach with the pods that the pigs were eating, but no one gave him anything. When he came to his senses, he said, "How many of my father's hired men have food to spare? And here I am starving to death. I will set out and go back to my father and say unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you, and I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Make me like one of your hired men." So he got up and went to his father. But while he was still a long ways off, his father saw him
and was filled with compassion for him and ran to his son and threw his arms around him and kissed him. May God have a blessing to the reading of his awesome word. Like talk with you briefly, and not just for the graduate, just for everyone. From the fault, it's not all it's cracked up to be. It's not all it's cracked up to be. Oh, I know you graduates, boy, y'all getting ready to graduate, walk across that stage. But something, a conversation had been said a long time ago before graduation. And we all have said the same exact words. I can't wait till I get out on my own. I can't wait to get my apartment, my ride, be my own boss, be a shot caller, big baller. But Jesus illustrates the point here in this lesson that you're not the first person to say this, and you won't be the last. But Jesus points out that God rejoices over one lost sinner that repents and finds forgiveness. In our text this morning, a father had two sons. The younger son displayed a rebellious, "You owe me" spirit by asking for his share of the father's estate. This would have been one-third of the total estate. The father could either grant the inheritance before or after his death. But this son wanted or asked for a special exemption to the plan. I want my share of your estate now, instead of waiting until you die. This showed an arrogance, a disregard of the father's authority of being head of the family. Not all of our children, but the mentality of our children today is a "you owe me" mentality. Don't want to work for nothing. Lounge in the bed. Get up when they get ready. Play the game all day. And when you ask them to do something, they want to suck their teeth. They've gotten to the point that they think that the world owes them something. But they'll realize real fast and in a hurry that it ain't all it's cracked up to be. Now, a lot of us that have said amen at these few statements, I really like to say that they didn't learn this on their own. A lot of times they have watched us as when mama and daddy, grandma and granddaddy and them, amen, because there are some grandparents that are still raising our children, amen, and so they have watched us when mama and daddy and grandma and them have worked hard all their life, and all of a sudden when they pass, we fight over something we didn't work for. And so while they're sitting back and watching us, they think that this is the norm. And because we don't wake them up in the morning and give them some chores, they think that they can breeze through life. Amen. But here at the arrogance of the son's request, the father clearly illustrated God's love. Yes, the love that would allow rebellion, yet respect a man's will. The father knew what would happen to his son, but he allowed him to go his course. Yes, just a few days later, after the son had received his portion, yeah, the young man went on his way, indicating that this was his plan all along. Yeah, he wanted to live his own way, be his own master, get out up from under the rules of the house and daddy. Yeah, money was his ticket, so he took it and ran. Yes, he decided that he was going to a distant land, and there he wasted all of his money on useless, shameless, corrupt living. Yeah. I want to let you know, I'm going to give you a couple of little gold nuggets that I want you to remember, if you don't remember nothing else in this message, that you will always have some leeches, whether people or things, that will suck the life out of you. Yeah, you'll have some leeches, whether people or things, that will suck your resources dry. Yeah, you're getting money and that money is already burning a hole in your pocket. Yeah, but you ought to be able to take that money and put it into a savings account, because you're going to need it after a while. Yeah, but I know it's going in one ear and out the other. Maybe it's just going upside your head and bouncing off. Amen. But you've got to realize that there are folk that know you green. They see the milk dripping out from behind your ears. They smell the Similac that's on your breath. The Infamil that's dripping out from around your chin. And they know that they can get what they want to get out of you. It don't matter whether or not you're going to college or in the work field. There are some leeches that will rub up against you. Let you think that, oh, we the best of friends. Yeah, but they are looking to get exactly what you have. And while you are going to college or going in life, they'll get up to you, and long as you're footing the bill, they're your buddy. Long as you puff giving and you paying for the package, yeah, they'll be your friend. Long as you buying rounds for everybody, yeah, they'll be your friend. As long as you're putting gas in your car and they're running out your gas. Oh, but you can't wait to get out that house. But whoa, when you get out that house, you got to find you a place to stay. And they don't mind sucking out your resources, because they'll give you a one-room apartment. It really ain't but one room, because it's the bedroom, the living room, and the kitchen all together. And they'll charge you $800 to $2,000 for rent. Well, I'd rather tell you, if you're going to pay that amount of money, you might as well go ahead and get you a house. Amen. Something you're going to own after a while, but you ain't thinking that far ahead now. You're just glad to get out of the house. Amen. And so you think you got it going on. And so you decide that you'll get this apartment. But then them leeches done rubbed up against you and say it's a party over here. Celebration time over there. You're going to stank your leg over here. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. It's a party always going on when you're footing the bill. And so you out all types of night. But then you forgot that you got a light bill. Water bill. Yeah, the car that you've been riding around in got to have some insurance. Got to put some gas in the car. But oh, you're a big baller shot caller. You are the man, girl. You are all that and a bag of chips. And you decide that you're going out, and all of a sudden you realize there ain't no food in the house. All of a sudden, the money starts to run out. Your money looking funny, your change acting strange, and ain't none of them going to your pocket. You're going to realize real fast it ain't all it's cracked up to be. Sometimes young people have burnt their bridges and they're not able to go back home. And so you have all these friends that was in your corner. But when the money begins to run out, they begin to leave out. They don't invite you to the parties no more. Yeah, they're not even riding in your car. Yeah, and to make matters worse, they begin to turn on you. But you're still trying to hang around with them. You're, as long as you got the clothes, you buying them expensive jeans, you got the fresh fly outfits, you got the new kicks that ain't nobody else got. But then when your money begins to run out and your stomach begins to stick to the back of your spine, then them folks are no longer around you. Yeah, when the money runs out and the friends are to become few. Yeah, and you'll realize that your status ain't on the status quo no more. Yeah, all of a sudden, when the money begins to run out, then as this young man learns in this lesson, a great famine will come your way. Yeah, and what I mean by famine is that hard times are going to knock on your door. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You were one while you were running the water, taking you a 30-minute bath. Amen. But now you just hitting and missing. At one time, you used to leave the lights on and forget they on and go outside and play like you want to play. But now all of a sudden, you cutting the lights off. When them bills begin to come in and hard time begin to hit you, oh, the first thing that come out your mouth is, I wish I were back home with mom and daddy. And some of the grown folks saying that same thing right now. Oh, that I wish I were back home with mama and daddy. Life does not care about you. Life is a dog-eat-dog world. Yeah, life will suck the fun out of life. When you were once smiling and having a good time, now everything makes you frown. Am I talking to anybody in here this morning? This young man was losing money, losing status, losing his appetite. No, his appetite wasn't gone. He just didn't have no food to fill it. Amen. But this famine came through this land, and this boy didn't have no money to buy even food. This young man became so desperate. Yes, that he began to work feeding pigs. After life sucks you dry, hard times will knock you on your behind. Yeah, it'll suck you so dry till it'll cause things to happen in your life. Some things that you would never normally do will begin to be your status quo. Yes, according to Moses' law, pigs were unclean animals. And to protect themselves from being defiled, the Jews wouldn't even touch them. Amen. Aren't you glad you ain't no Jew? Amen. I love a little bit of bacon and ham, even though it make my blood pressure go up. Amen. But I still eat it a little bit every now and then. Yeah. But here they didn't want to have to touch them to defile their body.
All right.
But for a starving Jew, here he stood feeding pigs. This was a humiliating job. And when you get on your own and you think that you're all that and things are not going to affect you, you are immune to the bills, you're immune to the lifestyle, you're immune to the predators that are preying on your resources, it'll cause you to take jobs that are not in your major. It'll cause you to do some things that you got a degree in one thing, but you just got to settle for whatever comes your way. Yeah. If you wind up finding yourself in a hog pen. Yeah, if you don't know what a hog pen is, a hog pen is where the hogs reside. Yeah, in the mud and the water, the feces, the urine are all mixed up in your mud. Yeah, the things of life that don't mean you no good are sitting in the hog pen. There are folks that don't mean you no good, they are sitting in the mud. After a while, you begin to stink like a pig. You begin to smell like a pig. You begin to even sometimes be covered in the mud. And folks can look at you and say, if you look like a duck and you quack like a duck, it might be Affleck. They'll put you in categories that you didn't grow up in. Yeah, life has a way of making you dress like a, look like a, act like a. Just because the world standards say it's all right to dress a certain way, it'll cause you to overlook what the devil is trying to portray. This young man finds himself in the hog pen. Let me tell you something, sisters and brothers. God will always show you what they gonna be like before you go any further with them. If they ain't working when you got them, they gonna be broke when you get them. I don't know about you, I can do bad by myself. Before I got with Sister McSwain, used to go to the club, and you got some pretty sisters that's in the club. They got their hair all did up, and they looking all pretty. Amen. That's probably why they got the lights dimmed down, so you won't see what they look like. Woo! But, you know, Destiny Child came out with a song, Can You Pay My Bill? And so I decided to go talk to this young lady. And she turned around and said, Can you pay my bill? I looked at her and I said, Can I pay your what? She said, Can you pay my bills? I said, No, but if they're your bills, you pay them, and you get back with me when you get them paid. You wasn't getting me in that trap. Mm-mm. No. But oh, this young man finds himself in the hog pen. There, here he is, humiliated. No one gave him anything. The guys and fellas and sisters he used to party with are now driving by. Yeah, they act like they don't know him anymore. Yeah, yeah, he was neglected and insignificant to them. Yeah, he had truly sunk to the depths. Sitting among some pigs here that he thought that he was no better. Nobody fed him. Yeah, 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 he was sitting there down in the slumps, down in the dumps, humiliated, broke, busted, and disgusted. Yeah, but here he is sitting in the hog pen watching some hogs that were being fed better than him. So then his mind reflects back to home. No money, no dignity. He thought he had no claim to sonship. Yeah, but at Father's house, he said, if I can just go back home to Daddy, I can confess my sin and ask him to hire me as a hired hand. Yes, the key word to the plan as he began to contemplate. He turned around and said, I think I ought to go back home. Yes, and I'll say, Father, I've sinned against heaven and you. Yes, I want to say, Father, I'm sorry. Yeah, he wanted to repent of his selfishness. Yeah, that led him to leaving home. Yeah, he said, Father, yeah, I was stuck on stupid.